Hello everyone. The lack of official SDXL support for Automatic 1111 can be frustrating, especially for those interested in stable diffusion and AI art through LoRA training. But don't despair. If you're passionate about stable diffusion and exploring the artistic potential of LoRA in AI art, we have exciting news for you. In this YouTube video, we'll unveil the Automatic 1111 official SDXL support, making stable diffusion and LoRA training in AI art more accessible and seamless than ever before. So, if you're ready to unleash your creativity with stable diffusion and AI art using LoRA, stay tuned and let's dive into the world of Automatic 1111 official SDXL support. First of all, I would like to thank all of you who installed the SDXL web UI extension. I learned a lot about the stable diffusion process and the components of stable diffusion when I developed in the extension. I hope that experience would bring you more extensions for the web UI in the future. Today I am going to show you the release candidate of the official Automatic 1111 SDXL supported version. By the time you watch this video, the official 1.5 may be released, but you can still keep watching to see which functions are still working and which are not. Let's go to the Automatic 1111 GitHub homepage. Version 1.4 is already from 3 weeks ago. Do you believe that they did not do anything about the SDXL? I don't believe it. So I started to look into the branch. There is a branch called SDXL. Obviously, they are working on it. The last commit to this branch is 4 days ago. When will they release the new version? Let's scroll down to see if there is any information. The commit message here is SDXL support. Okay. Let's look at the branch again. This time look at the tag. There's a tag name version 1.5RC. What is this 1.5RC for? Scroll down a bit. There is a change log. What is this? Version 1.50. SDXL support. Finally. Awesome. How can we try it? Let's try it today. Go to the Stable Diffusion Web UI folder. First, we need to get all the updated code. Type git pull. And then we need to fetch the tags. In the terminal, type git fetch all tags. It will then fetch all the tags to your local copy. Next, git checkout tags version 1.5RC. You are now in version 1.5RC branch. You can now start the web UI as usual. It looked exactly the same as before. Where to download the models? Go to Hugging Face Stability AI homepage. You can see the SDXL base model and SDXL refiner models here. For the base model, click the File tab. Scroll down. Download the safe tensors file. For the refiner model, click the File tab. Scroll down. Download the safe tensors file. Where should we put the SDXL model? Put it into the usual stable diffusion model directory. I have already downloaded the safe tensors files and put them there. We can then choose the XL-based safe tensors. You can see that the web UI is loading the SDXL checkpoint. The model is loaded. Okay. We can try it now. I will use this prompt. And a negative prompt. I choose the OLA sampling method this time. Change the steps to 30. Change the width and height to 1024. We are ready now. January. It is running. A sample also appeared. Problem. There is an error. What to do? Kill the app first. He said we can try in our half VAE. Copy in our half VAE. And then open the web UI user file. Add the no half VAE to the command line arguments. Save the file. Restart web UI. Okay, it's ready. Generate again. Okay, this time, the image can be rendered. It looks pretty nice. Let's try batch size of 2. Generate. No problem. Beautiful. Try to send image to image. Good. Everything's here. Kept the default settings. January. Okay. Let's try to use the Refiner checkpoint. Hey there. If you're enjoying the content so far, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. By hitting that subscribe button, you'll be the first to know when we release new videos. Don't forget to turn on notifications as well, so you never miss out. The checkpoint is loaded. January. Okay, this is the results using the Refiner checkpoint. Both SDXL can do the image-to-image function. We go back to the text-to-image. Try to use the Refiner checkpoint this time. January. It seems like the Refiner can also do the text to image. When I was testing, it cannot. Anyway. Let's try the extensions. First, change the checkpoint back to SDXL base model. Try the control net. I have the stick figure image. Enable the open pose. January. No. There is an error. control net is not compatible with SDXL yet. What about LoRA? Let's try to use the version 1.5 base LoRA. I will use the Kirsten-Dunst LoRA model. Add it to the prompt. Generate. No. Dimension not matched. Okay. Do we have LoRA model for SDXL? Yes. I've trained one. Let's try it out. Change the LoRA model name. January. Seems working. Sample look like my LoRA object. Out of memory. Never mind. Kill the web UI. Restart it. Generate. This time it worked. You can see that this is a virtual girl I always used. Wow. It's wonderful. Can the LoRA work in image to image? Sent image to image. Kept all the default settings. Generate. Okay. No problem. But not too much difference. What about the refiner checkpoint? Will it get better results? After it is loaded. Generate. No. There is some error. It seems the refiner cannot use LoRA models. If you want to switch back to the stable diffusion 1.5 version, change the checkpoint to any version 1.5 base model. After it is loaded, kill the web UI. In the terminal, type git checkout master. Restart the web UI. And now you will get back your latest web UI. Conclusion. SDXL supported is coming in version 1.5. Image to image is supported. Refiner worked. LoRA is supported. ControlNet not supported at this moment. Thank you very much. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about stable diffusion and LoRA training, hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss a video. I will put up the other video soon. You can also find all the models and images in my Patreon account. The link can be found in the description. Thank you and see you in the next video.